Graph the function f of x equals negative 2 times x plus 3 squared plus 4. This is a quadratic function because of the squared, and it's in vertex form. So here's how you find the vertex. You have the x plus 3. You can set that equal to 0. So you subtract 3, and you get x equals negative 3. So that means the x coordinate of your vertex is negative 3. And then the y coordinate is just right here. It's plus 4, so negative 3 comma 4 is your vertex coordinate. Put you right there. Now this x plus 3, it's the vertex form is x minus h. And so you could also, instead of going through the process of taking this x plus 3, setting it equal to 0, you just remember this x plus 3 is a translation 3 to the left. And the plus 4 is 4 up. If you think of your parabola translating 3 to the left and 4 up, that will get you to the exact same place as the process I just used. That's up to you. Okay, now we need to figure out the other points on this parabola. And what we're going to do is use this negative 2 to help. So we're going to have negative 2x squared as our kind of basis for calculating the other points. So I'm going to figure, okay, 1 to the right. So negative 2 times 1 squared is negative 2 times 1, or negative 2. So I'm going to write 1 and down 2. And the next point I'm going to use is 2 to the right, so I'm going to have negative 2 times 2 squared. That's the same thing as negative 2 times 4, which is negative 8. So I'm going to go 2 to the right from the vertex and then 8 down. 2, 4, 6, 8. Right there. Now let's try 3. Negative 2 times 3 squared. That's negative 2 times 9, which is negative 18. So 3 to the right, and then 18 down. So let's see, that is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18 down here. Kind of off the grid. So this is an optional point down here. You don't have to use it. I like to try to use it to help guide my parabola when I get further away from the vertex, but that's totally up to you. Now I'm going to reflect the points through the axis of symmetry, which is a vertical line through the vertex. And you know, if it helps you with the reflection, you can draw that axis of symmetry, especially if it's not on the y-axis. Let me switch colors here. And I'm just doing this to help with my reflection. You may not have to draw that line. You'll notice when you go to draw your parabola, if it's not reflected properly, it won't have the symmetry you're looking for. Okay, so now I'm going to draw the parabola. Okay, so there's our parabola. So I went ahead and determined the vertex, or the shift, or translation, you may want to call it. And then I plotted the vertex, and then I used the negative 2 because that's our vertical stretch. And it also turned out to be a reflection. Notice how it's open down. And then I used the negative 2 and the x squared to calculate the other points. Then I reflected through the axis of symmetry, and then finally drew the parabola.